Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. Tylenol or Advil, both work great for controlling mild pain, but what if your pain is more severe? Is it safe to take these two common over-the-counter medications together? Well, in this video, I'm going to answer that question. In addition, we'll go over the most important differences between Tylenol and Advil, as well as discuss potential side effects that you need to know. Let's get started. Now, if this is the first time you are watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live a healthy and active lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. So let's first talk about Tylenol. Tylenol or acetaminophen is perfectly safe to take as long as you don't have any liver disease. And that's because Tylenol is cleared from the body by the liver. So if you do have liver problems, then you will have decreased clearance of Tylenol and it can build up to dangerous levels in your body and that can result in acute liver failure. Now with that said, if you don't have any liver problems and Tylenol does work well to control your pain, then it is actually a great treatment option in providing short-term pain relief. The current accepted maximum dose of acetaminophen for those with normal liver function is 3 grams per day, and that comes out to a maximum of 2 extra strength Tylenol every 8 hours. And what about Advil, also known as ibuprofen? Ibuprofen is an NSAID, which stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Ibuprofen actually works really well in treating short-term pain because it has both anti-inflammatory and pain-relieving properties. And that's why many clinical trials comparing ibuprofen and acetaminophen find that ibuprofen has superior pain-relieving effects. But it's important to point out that everybody's body is slightly different, and so neither of the two drugs will be effective for everyone. The other thing about NSAIDs is that they have a much more dangerous side effect profile, especially when compared to Tylenol. When taken for a long period of time, NSAIDs can cause problems to the heart, to the kidneys, and to the stomach, and they can also increase your risk for heart attacks and strokes and can cause dangerously high blood pressures. So anyone with any type of cardiovascular disease or kidney disease needs to be extremely cautious when using NSAIDs. Similarly, anyone with really bad gastroesophageal reflux disease will also want to be very careful. Now, with that said, when used sparingly, they can be effective in treating short-term pain, but they should never be used long-term without first checking in with your doctor. Now, a great alternative to all of this is to use a topical NSAID such as diclofenac gel. This gel is applied to the skin and it acts locally. It's got both the pain-relieving and anti-inflammatory properties of ibuprofen without any of the side effects. It's going to work really well on painful conditions that are closer to the skin, but not as well for deep aches such as the low back or the hip. Diclofenac gel is available over-the-counter at any pharmacy or online. Okay, so those are the differences between ibuprofen and acetaminophen. Individually, they work great in controlling mild to moderate pain, but what if your pain is more severe? Can you take the two together or even alternate between them? And the answer is yes. Because they are cleared by different organs, it is perfectly safe to take them together or alternate between them to control your pain. But then the next question to ask is, does it work better? And here, the data is mixed, but many studies suggest yes, the two work better together in controlling pain. This study was a randomized controlled trial comparing an opiate medication, oxycodone, to combination ibuprofen and acetaminophen in patients presenting to the emergency room with some type of extremity pain. Now, we know opiate medications such as oxycodone are extremely strong pain medications used to treat the most severe types of pain. But what the researchers found was that combination ibuprofen and acetaminophen was as effective as treating pain as taking oxycodone. Similar results have been found for taking combination ibuprofen and acetaminophen in other painful conditions such as dental procedures as well as in low back pain. Now, I also want to point out that pain medications are not your only option in controlling pain, especially if you have chronic muscular pain. I've found that people who take a multimodal approach have the best results. I talk about the most important details you need to know in this video here, so check that out next.